Y'all are loving this series. First of all, I don't work jobs, bitch. I am a job, okay? Fuck those retail jobs. If you got a retail job right now, I know what you're going through. Baby, this verse goes to you. If you got a retail job right now and you're watching this video, I want you to comment under the video. Yes, sis, I got a retail job and I'm trying to get the fuck up out of there. Listen to this verse.
I make them hold up.
When I walk past these.
Turn it up. Got a nigga from Cuba. Got more work than a tutor. Scooter.
That is very relatable. Woo, I'm fucking my little bun up. Hold on. Let me relax. Because, bitch, I'm very much still employed. I'm not a city girl. You feel me? Not just yet. Hey, y'all. What's up? It's Chris, a.k.a. Honey Buns, back at it again. Oh, my God. I ain't like that. Back at it again with... What the fuck? Why am I not getting this right? Hey honeys, it's Chris aka Honey Buns back at it again with another video, and y'all already know what time it is. It is another story time. You guys really enjoyed the retail job story time yesterday, so I'm gonna give y'all another one. I asked y'all to vote on Instagram. Y'all already know how this thing go. I post, you vote, I do the video. If you don't follow me on Instagram, then you're not able to vote. So you don't know what's gonna happen. You just clicking in and you just tuning in every time you see a bell notification come through on YouTube, which I appreciate. But baby, get interactive. Get with the honeys. Okay, get with the crew. We're winning over here. Follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, and TikTok below. Get into it. But yes, without further ado, we're gonna go ahead and jump into this video. When I used to work at, focus in, follow with me. When I used to work at Always 22, I used to work at the store called Always 22. All right, you got it? Okay, good. You got it. All right, let's go. You got it. You smart. I know you do. So, boom, let's get into it. Let's not even play charade. Like, I want to get into the tea because y'all don't be knowing that these retail jobs really be having the co-workers stressed out. That's why when y'all be asking us, hi, I'm over here looking for a banana yellow crop top because I have these really cute summer shorts. Why we be egging you like, because I'm over here stressed out about the 15 million things I have to do. So when I used to work at Always 22, girl, they used to be so dramatic. Like, when I say dramatic, like, every day was a fashion show. First of all, every day was a fashion show, not because it was in your contract to come stylish and cute at work. No. Because you just came to work every day like it was a fashion show because everybody goes in for... Ooh, I almost said it. Everybody goes in Always 22. Like, you are not going to tell me you have not been to the mall and not just slid by there for a little choker. Slid in there for a little pocketbook. Slid in there for a little $2 shirt. Baby, everybody goes in there, but I'm going to fill y'all in with the tea. Like, let's get into it. So, I'm in college at this time. I'm in my school or whatever. So, I was like, I need a job. I need some extra coin because, baby, I got tired of calling my mama like, hey, Ma, can you send me some coin? Hey, Ma, can you send me some coin? And she looking like, okay, I just sent you coin. And, you know, when you in school, your parents be supporting you. But if you got parents like mine, they support them, but only so much. Okay? So, you better go out here and get a bag. And plus, that's just my character. Like, I need to be making money. I need to be doing something because I can't just be out here just asking and not doing. You feel me? Anyway, I end up applying to Always 22. End up getting a job. Interview was easy. Like I said, all I want to make sure is you can dress, you cute, and you can stand on your feet. That's it. Baby, they don't care about how much you know how to count. They don't give a fuck your work history. As long as you can stand, you dress, and carry yourself nice. And baby, you gonna come to work and you look cute. You got the job. Like, that's just it. So I get the job, whatever. And when I went to school, public transportation was just not the vibe. Like, every day it was like, how I'm gonna get to work. And if you live down south, you don't live like up north, I'm pretty sure y'all don't know what I'm talking about. But down south, yeah, try to catch a bus to the mall and see how long it takes you to get to the bus. Just wait on it. I'm waiting on the North Carolinians to comment in the chat. Because y'all know. Impossible. So anyway,
girl, I used to have to ride the bus to go to work. So I used to never like riding the bus, like, baby. It was always pumps, drunks, and skunks on the goddamn bus.
And, baby, when I used to see me get on the bus, it was always like, you're doing the most. And I used to be like, baby, I don't have a dollar. I don't have a dream. I don't have a coin. I don't have a quarter. I don't have shits for you. Don't come over here asking me for nothing. I will spray you, sir. Sir. Like, to really get aggressive with them dang homeless men. Homeless men be out of control. They don't give a damn. They don't give a fuck. They will walk up on you. They want that dollar. They starting to ask for Cash App now, I think. Anyway, besides the point. Girl, so when I'm working at Always 22, they used to be so dramatic on, like, every day is a fashion show. So, like I said, you used to want to be dressed up, but, like, the co-worker would be like, okay, what is the style you're giving today? Like, the manager there, she was an older white lady, and she used to always be like, you know, what inspired your look today when you come into work? So, you know, I mean, every look you have to be like, oh, I'm giving 90s, I'm giving that. But I think she just did that with the new hirees. She wasn't really worried about, like, the old people that came in. Like, she was just like, oh, hey, Tammy, hey, Tom, hey, Shaniqua. But me, she's like, okay, Chris, hi, what inspires your style today? So, baby, you know, I used to be rich. Well, so I thought in college. You know, I used to have my little days. I would always, you know, kind of give like 90s vibe, or I'm giving retro, or I'm giving biker tees. Like, I was always giving something like that. I mean, baby, I do like Always 22's dress code, because, baby, you can go in there in crop top, booty shorts, you can wear whatever you want as long as it's stylish. And, like, I rocks with that. That was the only thing. That's my only good complaint about working at that goddamn store, literally.
So, girl, the real tea is, it used to just always be a goddamn mess. Like, a mess. Like, it was like, there's no point in cleaning up that store. It's no point in cleaning up that store because it's not going to stay clean. I remember my very first few days, like, baby, first of all, it's no training module. I think you do modules for, like, 2 days. But, baby, like, the modules are just simply, like, hi. How to greet people, how to talk people, how to, you know, implement style. Like, that was all the fucking training was. Like, can you match a green shirt with white pants? Like, that was it. It was nothing hard. Anyway, moving on. So, I just remember when I used to work on the sales floor, motherfuckers would come in and, like, y'all, if you ever been into the store, you know, when you're going there and ask them, like, for something that they may have seen online, like, hey, I'm looking for this shirt right here. Baby, this store is unorganized. Just because I got this little yellow tassel and I'm walking around thinking I look like I know what I'm doing, whole time, I don't even really know what's in here for real. Like, I would be in there putting, like, go bags back and be running into stuff like, oh, this is cute, and, like, go hide it for myself. Like, I'd be in there shopping because it'd be like people will buy stuff from online and do online in-store returns. So it'd be stuff like that. Anyway, let me get into some of the specific stories that pissed me off working at that goddamn store. So one day, this is like a Saturday, okay? And let me tell you something about Always 22. Baby, if you work on the weekends, you finna get work the dog shit. Like, when I say the dog, they finna work the dog. And don't be closing. Oh, baby, let me tell you. So I was closing on a Saturday night, okay? Came in at 4, got off at 10, okay? So when the mall closed. So, girl, I get there, whatever. I'm pumped because this is my very first few days. You know, I'm like, okay, yeah, I got my little outfit on. I'm dressed 90s. I'm giving you a look. I'm giving you a team. When I get there, I come in. She's like, hi, Chris. You know, it's your first day on the floor. I hope you're excited. You look really nice. What impacted your style? So, I gave her my little whatever. I was dressed like that day. I can't even remember. So, I go in, you know. And I'm in there working or whatever. She's like, okay, Chris, you're going to cover 2 sections today. I feel like you got it with your retail experience. Like, she was an old white lady. So she was just, like, she was old, but she was also kind of, like, young acting, but she was old. Because she was like, yeah, I totally think you can handle 2 spots. Like, we're going to just start you off in Soho. Soho, the room Soho, and the men's room. So you'll just be doing both. The men's room is kind of slow, and Soho's more of our, like, upscale outfits, but I think you can handle it. So I'm like, okay, cool. Like, sis, no problem. So, baby, I'm doing my little go bags. You know, of course, the girl from the dressing room, she's putting the stuff on my rack. I'm putting shit back. Bank, boom, bank, boom, bank. No problem. Where the problem started to come in with
was the people that came into the store. So mind you, I think, I don't remember what I had on, because I had on like this crop top sweater, and I had these fishnet underneath. I had the fishnet underneath these baggy jeans, but the fishnets were high-waisted and the jeans were low-cut and the shirt was kind of like baggy, and I had on like some Rihanna, not creepers. I had on like Rihanna, I had on Pumas. So I'm in there just minding my business, and at the time I had braids because it was like right around my birthday. So I'm walking around, you know what I'm saying? I'm doing my little go back to my whatever, bad, y'all. Motherfuckers always want to call while I'm in the middle of a goddamn video, but let my ass be in here, bored and bored. Don't nobody want to call my damn phone, but the moment I hit motherfucking record, now y'all want to call a bitch. No. So anyway, what was I saying? Yeah. So these little gremlins run into Always 22. They come running to the dang on store, you know, grabbing stuff, acting like, I mean, I get it. You know what I'm saying? It's your first time in the mall. Your mama finally let you off the leash. Like, you don't know how to act. So they in my section, you know, just, you know, grabbing stuff, going to the room, going to the dressing room, trying on clothes. You know what I'm saying? They having them a good time. They not buying that. And trust me, I done been there, done that. I already know what y'all doing. Here was my only issue. I'm over here folding my table, and y'all want to come mess with the shorts and crop tops at my table. Okay, that's not what we're about to do. That's not what we're about to do. So I come over like, hi, would you like me to help you with anything? This little chunky little let me not, because I have to learn how to let stuff go. This little chunky little messy head little hoe little girl gonna look at me like, no, I don't need any help. She had so much attitude in her little body. I was confused, like, what did I say to trigger you? Because, baby, all I asked you was, did you need a little help? Because clearly you're over here with the smalls and you're definitely an XL. So I'm trying to help your ass out so you don't mess up the shorts I just folded. Period. And they running out. They grabbing in my little section. They grabbing little crop tops and stuff. I'm just calm down. So I was like, you know what? I'm not even going to touch that table till after they leave, because I'm tired of touching it. And they keep coming back and forth grabbing little stuff off the table, because you can only take so many items in the dressing room. But I guess they decided they wanted to try on the whole fucking table. I don't know. So the whole time I'm over in the men's section while the little girls are like over there, you know, in my other section trying on, grabbing stuff off the table. I wasn't finna be over there, like, standing over y'all. Y'all keep going over there messing it up. I'm not finna keep doing that. So I'm over there in the men's section. All I hear on the walkie is,
so I was looking a little rough.
Okay. I was like, yeah, I'm on it. I'm just over here in the men's section. I was gonna wait till the girls left the table. I didn't wanna just, you know, keep redoing what they kept messing up, you know, so I was just giving them time, but I'm on it.
She was like, yeah, Soho never needs to look messed up.
Never. Impossible. Like, impossible.
You know the Always 22, that one little area where it's like the clothes are a little bit more bougier than the other side. You know that little one little area?
Yeah, she was like, that side never needs to mess up because that's like the front of our store. Like, that's the first thing they see when they come in. I'm like, yes, it's like I'm trying, but it's like, dang, like, do you see the little girls coming over here playing damn Play-Doh's claws in here? Like, the fuck is going on? So she's like, yeah, like, I just need you to really focus on this area. The men area never gets dirty. You don't have to go over there, ever. Like, you barely have to go over there. So I'm like, okay, well, bitch, let me do this. Like, I got this. Let me do this. Like, I got it. Trust me. So that was, like, the one thing. Oh, and then the little girls came out, and they was trying to record me, like, take pictures of me while I was at work. Like, I was looking like a clown. So, you know me, I turned around and posed for them. Then they want to giggle out the damn door. Yeah, I should have goddamn karate kicked them in the back of their motherfucking head. The customers that be coming into the store usually just be, like, in a rush. Like, the kids, they be childish. But the people that's, like, around the 20-year-old, 19, 16-year-olds, like, they come in, they be coming in with a mission. Like, okay, I need a black crop top, blue shorts, and a damn yellow skirt. Like, I gotta go. Like, I ain't got time. Like, I'm running out of shit. Like, everybody comes in that store. So, you know, it would be people coming in. They would have, like, a picture on their phone. Be like, do you have something like this? And I be looking like, girl, like, it is what it is. Like, if it's here, if it ain't, it ain't. Like, I mean, like, and the inventory be, like, out of this world. Like, you would be in there and you'll find, like, something that's really cute.
But that be like the only one. Like somebody done bought the ish online and then brought it in and returned it. And then it's like, this the only one. And then sometimes you'll find shit that don't even belong in the store. Like, how is this in the store? Like, whose coat is this? Like, girl, dramatic. Another story that happened to me is when I was on the goddamn register. Let me tell you something again with retail. I don't appreciate how y'all be thinking I'm supposed to ask somebody every time do they come through the line, do you want a credit card? Do you want a store credit? Do you have a return? Do you want a rewards points? Like, you asking too much. You want me to ask all of that and sign them up and get the line down. Like, baby, one of these are not going to happen. You choose, babe. Which one is more important? Think. Okay? Because I'm not finna keep stressing myself out. And then you want to be able to walkie like, hey, how are those credits sounding? And girl, don't let you get a credit. Baby, you're the star pupil of the goddamn day. Okay? Because baby, them people was not signing up for them credit cards. Baby, half of the people working there ain't even got no credits to get a credit card. So what are you saying got me steady asking? We need to ask every customer. So girl, I ain't have the issue like I had at the other job. But I used to just hate like having to ask everybody like, would you like a credit card? And then like, ooh, they be so motherfucking rude. Like, if I ever go through a line and you ask me, hi, would you like a store credit card? Do you want the store credit? Do you want our rewards card? I'll be like, no good. Or I'ma throw a joke like, girl, I can't get no more credit cards. Like, I'ma be real nice. Motherfuckers wanna be like, this me. Hi, welcome to Always 22. Is this all you're getting today? Would you like to sign up for our store? No. No, I don't. Yeah, that's all I got. Let me finish what the fuck I was gonna say. Shit used to make me so goddamn mad. I'd be like, you know what? Don't even put me on a register because I'm not gonna make it. And every day I would buy something. Like, it never failed. Like, I would always be doing go bags. Find something cute. I'm like, bro, I gotta get this. And then it be on my mind all day. It just be in the back of my mind. Like, if I go put it somewhere, it'll just be talking to me like, come by me. You know you want me. Like, I'd be like, bro, like, leave me alone. Get off me. Like, I do, like, yo, I used to buy clothes every single day. But we did get a discount, so that was the only, like, plus about working there. You did get a discount, but, baby, let me tell you something, baby. The discount did you no good when you ain't have no check. Because, girl, and then you could mess around and buy something, and it come off your check. Oh, baby, I ain't never do that. But, baby, listen. Deduct for it. Like, baby, they used to be in there deducting like hell. Like, this right here was, like, I think this is when I had made the decision to quit. But, I'm going to tell y'all the reason why I quit. But, this was, like, when I was like, yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm definitely quitting after this. So, I'm on the register, right? Now, mind you, this is, like, my third or fourth week. So, like, I ain't never really even been, you know, really ain't even, like, I kind of got a hang of things, but I'm not, like, a pro with the shit yet. So, like, with returns and stuff, you have to get, like, a manager's approval key to, like, to do a return. Like, I had only done, like, a couple of returns in my whole time working there. So, when I had got this one return, like, it was pretty much, like, this was just a drip. Like, I'm not even gonna explain. I'm just getting to the story time and I'm just let y'all hear it. So I'm at the register. It's a casual goddamn day. Okay, it's a casual goddamn Sunday. So I'm thinking like, okay, it's Sunday. We pass Saturday. Like by Friday, Thursday, the madness really starts Thursday. Thursday, you finna lose your mind. Friday, you done about lost it. Saturday, you insane. But Sunday, you be trying to just like, okay, I got my mind back. I'm trying to get it together. Like, it's just not that bad. So girl, this return was like, this lady had came in. I will never forget. She was like a mixed Puerto Rican, like real Cuban, like Cuban mommy. So she had came in. She had her little Forever 21, her little big glasses on. She came in like,
hey, I need to do a return. The dress did not fit.
So I'm like, okay, ma'am, I would love to take you here. You know, come on through my line. You know, what's wrong with the dress? Did it not work? Like, oh, you said it didn't fit. Okay, great. You know what I'm saying? Let me go ahead and just, you know, take it out. Do you have the receipt? Okay, great.
Yes, I have the receipt. You know, I guess the dress just did not work. The dress did not work. I mean, like, it just, the dress did not work.
Okay. Just so the dress didn't work. Great. So I'll go ahead and just put the dress didn't work in the comment section here. As I'm taking the dress out of the bag, I noticed that the underarms under the dress right here, this cut piece right here, they're severely white. The dress is black and they're severely white. Baby, you had on some Dove deodorant. You had, no matter what, you had on Degree Love. Yeah, I smell it. The Degree deodorant, I smell it on here. The tag is bent up. You had this dress on and now you're trying to return it and get your coin back because you only needed it for that one day for your daughter's quinceañera. That's the only reason why you needed a goddamn dress. Now you're trying to be slick and bring the shit back because the light bill's up. Stop fucking playing with me. Stop playing with me. She like, oh, no, man. Oh, the dress just did not fit. The dress did not fit. The dress did not fit. So I'm like, okay, ma'am. So I'm like, I call, you know, my manager. I'm like, hi, we have a return up here. I just need the key to do the return. So she's like, you know what? I'm close to the register. I'll just come up and just, you know, verify the return to make sure everything's good. Lord, this white lady come up here. She come by, she look at the dress, and she whispers, no. So I'm like, no what? Like, no, you're not gonna give me the key. No, no what? No what? So the lady just over there, she's still on her phone. She not even paying me no mind. She not even like giving me no time of day. So I'm sitting over there like, so the return, like I need to do the return for the lady's dress. Like she needs some, like a coupon. She's like, no, we can't return that. Like she's clearly worn that. Like that's really worn and sore. Like look at the underarms. They're white. They're musty. I'm like, Christy, yes, I see the must. I see it. Like, I see it. But like, you gonna tell her that? Cause I'm not finna tell her that. Cause she's gonna be amped up if I tell her. So are you gonna tell her? Cause I'm not finna tell her. So Chrissy's like, so somebody called her over the walkie in the back for something. And so she runs to the back. She's like, just handle it. Oh, okay. So I'm like, well, ma'am, unfortunately, due to the condition of the dress, I wouldn't be able to accept it back. So we wouldn't be able to take the return. She was like,
oh no, pero you're gonna take the return because I have the policy.
I'm like, yeah, I understand the policy, but like, you wore this. Like, so now I have to get, now I'm getting aggressive. Like, baby, you wore this. Like, you can't even lie. Like, this is a whole full day of wear and tear. Like, it's glitter and shit on it. Like, the underarms are sweated the fuck out. Like, it's a sweat stain going down the back. You can't hide it. It's a little icing at the bottom of the skirt part. Come on, love. Don't do that. So she like, no. I like, go get your manager. So I'm like, okay. So I'm like, hi, the lady with the dress would like to speak with you. She on the walkie like, no, bitches, no. Because you was the one that told me to tell her no. So what you should have did when she was up here and you told me to tell her no, what you should have did was you should have told her no and you should have made her. Don't try to put this on me like I'm the one stressing you the hell out. No. Anyway, so like basically that was that. She didn't get the return. She stormed out the store. I think she ended up like knocking some like leggings over. Oh, and that's another motherfucking thing. The table for the goddamn leggings. Oh my god, the leggings and the bandos, these right here in the leggings, be the worst tables to fix because, like, motherfucker, like, there is no organization in there. They don't like stack stuff like large, medium, small, extra small. No, they just go in there and fold shit to make it look neat because they be ready to leave the next day, to leave at night for the next day. And you be in there all night on the damn table doing leggings because motherfuckers done came and be like, nope, not my size. I mean, they be in there just going damn stupid. Like, nope. I'm like, okay. Like, I would literally see people like pull shit out. Oh, not my size. Throw it to the side. Oh, my size. And put it in a little carry-on bag. Like, baby, I used to want to see what the hell these motherfucking goddamn customers' house look like. Because it's no way you have any type of organization the way you throwing shit around in here. It's nope. Cut it. You're a dirty butt. You're a bum. You're a muff, bitch. You're a muff. You're musty, okay, bitch. I don't know what you got going on, but it ain't it. So, girl, when I say go backs, cleaning that stove, you don't be leaving that stove. Like, your schedule be to leave at 10. Babe, you not leaving till 1 in the morning. 1:30, 2 o'clock, 12 o'clock. And the store I worked at was a big store, so they used to want that shit to be clean for the next day. And, like, baby, I was in school. It was around finals time. My birthday was coming around the corner. Oh, and then I tried to get my birthday off. She thought telling me that she wasn't going to give me my birthday off was going to stop my birthday. Baby, I guess you must have forgot who was in control. I will clearly not show up like I didn't. Period. And that's when I decided to quit. After the dress incident and after y'all scheduled me on my birthday and I was in college, then I had got that second refund and then my taxes came and my mama gave me a G. Baby, I was like, yeah, I don't need this. I don't need this. Plus, I'm missing too much stuff on campus fooling with y'all, okay? Period. If you like that video, make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe. Again, it's Tuesday. I'm doing good, y'all. It's Tuesday. I done posted a video today, so don't clock me. If you don't follow me on Instagram, make sure you do that. I will be posting a poll for you guys to vote on for tomorrow's video, even though tomorrow's Wednesday, so more likely it'll be a wine Wednesday, and I'll just allow y'all to put your topics, or if you want me to speak on your specific situation, you know, on Wine Wednesday, we'll definitely do that. Probably won't drink wine, probably drinking some water, I don't know. But yes, I love y'all. Make sure you follow me, make sure y'all stay posting, make sure y'all stay active. I love you guys. I'm out. Brought my hips and make it wiggle, 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 make it wiggle.